What this comes down to for Sun Tzu is knowing yourself and knowing others. Remember what I said earlier, knowing yourself and knowing others, and you'll have every opportunity, you'll miss no opportunity to defeat the enemy. So this ability to read people, to be sensitive, it goes back to the collaboration. It plays on communication. We tend to be very good communicators. It's not a coincidence that women are in communications roles. And this plays into something else that I think is really, really important. And this is the idea of sensitivity and how you shape the perception of other people. How many women have been told or have heard it said about other women or are fearful of that being said about you? Something like this. Well, so-and-so is too aggressive. So-and-so is too assertive. It's okay. Well, there's a show of hand. Thank you. An honest person. Exactly. A lot of us have. Well, I don't mean it in a bad way, but you know, she's just a little too aggressive, a little too assertive. She shouldn't have to be like that, right? How many of us have heard that? Here's what I would love for you to take away. This is a relatively recent Stanford study of 132 business school graduates over an 8-year period. Here's what they found. Women who are aggressive, assertive, and confident. Those are all three good things, by the way. But can turn this on and off based on the situation, based on the circumstances. That timing I talked about earlier with Carly Fiorina, get more promotions than men, than other women, and men. What's the takeaway? Reading the environment. Now, some people are just numb to what's going on around them. We know those folks, right? We've seen that. It's like kind of bullying their way through, and it doesn't matter what people think. And that's, you know, there's different personality types. What I'm saying to you is don't be that person. Be sensitive. Pick up on those unspoken social cues that we women tend to be so good at and use it to your advantage. So be aggressive, be assertive, be confident, but also know how and when to dial it back, not to kowtow, not to duck your head in shame, but to know when to turn it off and on. See? That's the real art. The people who did the study call these women chameleons. They're able to assess the social situations to adapt their actions accordingly. So my advice to you, so you say, well, first you told us to be authentic, and now you're telling us to be a chameleon. So how do we bridge the gap? Well, I told you between those slides, it's a game, right? It's a game. It's not always fair. It's not about hard work. It's not about things all lining up evenly for everybody. So be an authentic chameleon. Be true to yourself. Be confident. Be sure of yourself. Be authentic. Know you can do it. Know you've done it. Be ready for whatever comes around the corner. And be ready to adjust to this conversation right here with this individual, because I know I've worked with him or her before, and I know what's going to help me get the result that I want. Make sense? Sun Tzu said this: all warfare is based on deception. Also a really quoted passage of his. So there are some business implications there about deception and being honest versus being dishonest, and I'm not going to get into all of that. But he also said, therefore, when able to attack, we must pretend to be unable. When employing our forces, we must seem inactive. When we're near, we must make the enemy believe that we are far away. When far away, we must make him believe that we are near.